Hare Krishna. If we don't sleep at the right time, we will sleep at the wrong time. Actually, for all of us, we have certain bodily needs which we need to fulfill. And sometimes we may think of our willpower of or our spiritual growth in terms of suppressing or denying our bodily needs. But the body cannot be cheated of its needs. Krishna cautions about this in the Bhagavad Gita in 6.16 and 17 when he's talking even about yogis who have renounced the world and gone to the forest. And about them he says, Natyashnatastu yogosti na chaikantam anashnataha na chati swapna shilasya jagrito naiva cha arjuna. He says, one who eats too much or eats too little. One who sleeps too much or sleeps too little. Such a person cannot become a yogi. And then the next verse he says, therefore be regulated. Regulate in food, sleep, recreation and work. And then one can, by that regulation, have a connection with Krishna, and that connection will lead us to liberation. Yogo bhavati dukkha. We don't want to work for the body in terms of pandering to its every desire. But we can't work against the body. Because the body is a machine. If we start abusing it, exploiting it, stretching it beyond its capacity, it will break down. So with respect to sleep, if we think that we can deny sleep, then we don't sleep at the right time, we'll find ourselves sleeping at the wrong time. We may end up sleeping when we are studying, when we are hearing, sometimes when we are driving, and that can lead to disaster. So the point of spirituality is not to deny our body or to deprive our body. The point of spirituality is to ensure that our body doesn't deprive us of our soul. That means in pandering to the body, we don't deprive ourselves of our spiritual growth. So for sustainable practice of spirituality, we need to harmonize the needs of the body, taking care of the needs of the body with taking care of the needs of the soul. So rather than becoming sleep deprived, we find out what is the adequate amount of sleep needed for us and take that, and then in the remaining waking time, we can be alert to focus on Krishna, focus on spirituality, focus on the philosophy that takes us towards Krishna, and thereby become devoted and absorbed in Him. Thank you. Hare Krishna.